Hey everybody, the Social Security cost of living adjustment for 2025 is finally official. We got the official numbers this morning. We're going to talk about what they are, what they mean to you, and other things you need to know. Before we dive in, please take a minute and check out the link you see on your screen, fool.com/Frankel. Get a message from my sponsor, The Motley Fool. It's the best way to support this work I'm doing on YouTube. And also, please hit subscribe to my channel. I cover Social Security and other financial topics very often. So please join me on this journey and ask me any questions you might have. So let's dive right in. I want to go ahead and share my screen. Okay, so I'm recording this the day the inflation data was released. That was October 10th. And that was the day the Social Security Administration announced its cost of living adjustment. If you're not familiar, I've done other videos about this in the past that really explain the process. But the main idea is that the Social Security cost of living adjustment is based on third quarter inflation. That is the inflation from July, August, and September. We had already seen July and August, and on October 10th, the inflation data, meaning the CPI consumer price index data from September, was released. And that was kind of the missing piece of the puzzle that was needed. And because of that, we now know that for 2025, I won't keep you in suspense. Retirees are going to get a 2.5% increase to their Social Security benefits. Now, that's the lowest that it's been in some time, but is pretty close to historical trends, as we'll get to in a minute. So a couple of things you need to know. I already mentioned that this is based on third quarter inflation data, and technically this is the 2024 cost of living adjustment, not just because it was announced in 2024, but because it technically goes into effect with December's benefits. But Social Security benefits are paid 1 month in arrears, so this will be reflected in the payment that you actually receive in January 2025, which is why it's generally re referred to as the 2025 cost of living adjustment, because that's when you'll receive it. But it actually takes place technically in late 2024. Not that anyone really cares about that. You'll get it with your January check, but that's, the behind the scenes of how it works. So if you see a 2.5 Social Security cost of living adjustment for 2024, that's what it's referring to. So what will this mean to you? So the short answer is, for the average retired worker, the cost of living adjustment will result in roughly $50 more per month from Social Security. Now, this is just an average. There are other types of Social Security beneficiaries other than retired workers. Spousal beneficiaries are one, survivor's benefits, if you're a widow or widower, that's one. Some children actually get Social Security benefits if their parents are retired. There's a bunch of different kinds of beneficiaries, disability benefits, and things like that. So that's just the average. It doesn't mean that your payment will go up by $50 a month. The Social Security Administration, or SSA, they estimate that the average retired worker will get $1,976 per month. That's just under $24,000 per year after the cost of living adjustment takes effect. So again, this is just an average, but here are some other numbers that the SSA released along with its announcement for the new cost of living adjustment. See the top line, retired workers. Right now, the average retired worker gets $1,927, and again, it rises by about $50, 49 to be precise. But there's the average impact on a married couple. Yeah, the average married couple that where both people get Social Security gets just over $3,000 today. Now, that includes married couples where both of them are getting retired worker benefits, where one is getting a retired worker benefit and one is getting a spousal benefit. That includes a big group of people. And for that group, the average is estimated to go up to $3,089. And for a disabled worker and family who receive benefits, that would be right, the average would go up from $2,757 a month, which where it is now, to $2,826 per month. So, of course, again, these are just averages. If you want to know what your own benefit is likely to be, just look at one of your monthly payments right now and multiply it by 1.025 to get a good estimate of what yours will be. Not an exact science. There are other things to consider, like that Medicare Part B premiums are generally paid from Social Security, for example. So that might not be an exact method, But in December, you will see a personalized cost of living adjustment notice that will be available in your My Social Security account. If you haven't created one already, all beneficiaries should have one. But if you haven't created one already, you can do so at ssa.gov, just so you're ready for whenever you are a Social Security beneficiary or when something important comes into your account. But you will be able to log in December and see a personalized estimate before the increased payments actually start appearing in your account. Now, I mentioned that this is the lowest it's been in a little while. If you look at the last bullet point on this slide, the last three cost of living adjustments were 3.2%, which we just got last year, 8.7% the year before when inflation was very, very high, and 5.9% before that. So this is the lowest out of the past 4 years. It's the smallest since 2021, which was under 2% before inflation really took off. But over the past 10 years, the average Social Security cost of living adjustment has been about 2.6%. So this is pretty in line with historical averages. And it's not a bad thing. It's a bad thing generally economically if you're getting an 8% cost of living adjustment because it means inflation is very, very high. A 2.5% cost of living adjustment means that inflation is not very high right now. So that means the price you're paying for goods and services is not rising rapidly like it has been in recent years. So it's a good thing. And of course, everyone wants to see their Social Security checks be as high as possible. But economically, this is not a bad thing. It's pretty in line with where it's been historically. So hopefully you found that informative. Also, the inflation data that was released today also impacts Social Security in a few other different ways. We have the Social Security earnings test, which tells you how much you can earn while collecting Social Security without your benefits being reduced. We have the maximum amount of wages or earned income that is subject to Social Security tax. That is inflation dependent as well as the maximum possible Social Security benefit every year. So we're running out of time in this one, but I will cover each of these in separate videos very soon. Again, please leave me some questions. I love talking about Social Security, answering questions on it, and hearing what you have to say about it. Do you think the cost of living adjustment accurately reflects the actual increased cost of living that you're facing right now, or do you not? I'd love to hear your thoughts on that. Again, I'll do my best to respond to every comment individually, but thanks for listening. I want to thank The Motley Fool for sponsoring this video. The Motley Fool is a company that provides investing insight and stock recommendations for investors of all skill sets and risk levels. You all know how much I love researching new stocks and trying to find the next best investment. So I'm proud to partner with The Motley Fool to bring you 10 stock picks from the popular product Stock Advisor. Stock Advisor has beaten the market by nearly 5 times. So go to fool.com/Frankel to get your 10 stock picks now. The Motley Fool Stock Advisor returns are 767% as of July 5th, 2024, and are measured against the S&P 500 returns of 163% as of July 5th, 2024.